swimming has been shown in the heaps of studies to help with your longevity. It literally helps you live longer.
Hey team, Brad here for The Run Experience. Now I'm a physiotherapist and a coach from Mount Maunganui, New Zealand. And in this video, I want to unpack why I think every runner should have swimming as part of their run training. Now I know this goes against the number one rule in training, which is specificity, but hear me out. Not only is swimming fantastic for running, but if you're over the age of 35, I think it's an integral part. It could be the missing link to improving your 5K time. I've been a runner and a triathlete since 1987. For 34 years, when I was injured and couldn't run, I swam. And when I came back from my injury, I realized there are so many benefits that overlay into the running. The number one is that it's so restorative and regenerative for your joints, while at the same time you're giving your cardiovascular system a really good workout. Number two reason why swimming is so good for running is it's a full body workout, especially for the upper body. When you combine the upper body with the kick, you get that nice cross body. It's fantastic for running coordination. Number three, when you do the push off off the side of the pool, it's a fantastic squat. So it basically helps work your big muscles in your legs, quads, hamstrings, and your glutes. Okay, so it's just a fantastic way to get all those leg muscles working. And then number four, some of the swim drills you do, especially the butterfly drills, really help with that full body coordination, really helping with flow, which again, progresses really well for running. Number five, swimming is fantastic for getting your breathing in sync with the body. So it really helps with that coordination. Now that really helps with your running. When you can get your breathing in time with your foot strike, it's the same with the swimming, getting your breathing in time with that strike rate. So it's another great chance to work on that breathing regulation. Number six, cold. When you swim in cold water, you get a whole multitude of positive effects in terms of cellular health, thermogenic regulation. There's so many fantastic effects to swimming in the cold water. So, how do you start your swim training? Well, if you can't swim, you need to get some one-on-one lessons. So one-on-one lessons will really help us iron out technique and get you going. So that's really, really important. And it's never too late to start. Now, if you can swim, then maybe three times a week in the off season, just to build that technique and that feel for the water. And then when your run training starts to ramp up, you can bring it back a bit to maybe just once a week, just to keep that feel up and have a nice easy session working on your cardiovascular system without putting too much strain on your joints. So, the big question, will swimming help improve your 5K run time? I believe it will. The fantastic thing about swimming is you can put in extra cardiovascular load in your week with minimal risk of injury. So you can load up that cardiovascular system with extra sessions and decrease the rate of injury. And this is really important as you get a little bit older. After the age of 35, 40 years of age, you might need to bring your running sessions down a little bit. And this is where swimming can help pump up that cardiovascular time and really help with your general fitness. And that will help with consistency, which will help improve your running times. All right, team, thanks for listening and watching. Hopefully you got a few really good tips there for your swim training and how to integrate it into your run training. I'll catch you on the next video. I'm off for a swim.